Entering data is probably going to take up the majority of your time when you're working with PASW. For instance, as I mentioned earlier, let's say you administer this test to 10,000 people. You literally have to put in each one of those questions for each one of those 10,000 individuals. But it must be done for proper analysis. So, let's see how we can enter in data by selecting our Data View tab. Once our questions have been defined as variables, when we switch back to Data View, we will see these variables listed from left to right towards the top of our interface. From here, we can go through our sample survey and we can actually input the raw results that we've obtained from each of our participants. So, for an example, let's say the first participant's name was Jane, and let's say she maintained about a B- average and she's 19 years old. What are the specs that we should add for her? First, we're going to type in her name under the name variable. Then, hit your tab key to move to the gender variable, and since she's a female, we're going to type a 1. Let's say Jane is highly disappointed because at her last finals, she didn't do as well as she thought, and she actually only maintained a C+ average, so her GPA is a 2.85. Let's press the tab key to move over to your GPA variable and type 2.85. Let's recall that for the age variable, we actually had defined groups. So instead of typing 19 for Jane, we're actually going to attribute a 1, which stood for 19 or younger. Let's move down to our next participant. His name is John. He actually is a graduate student and he has maintained a B- average. And he's actually 36 years old. So what are the specs for John? Let's first click within the name variable for our second case and type John. Press the tab key. Since John is a male, we're going to type in a 2 for his gender variable. And as maintenance of a B average, we're going to type in 3.25 as John's GPA. John is a 36-year-old graduate student. So instead of typing 36, do you guys recall what the number is we equated with that age group? That's correct. We attributed a 5 for those who are age 32 and over. For John, let's type in 5 in the age variable. That completes our section on entering data. So you would just basically continue through all of the variables and for each one of your participants. And once all of this raw data is entered, then you can finally begin your analysis on your information.